London Tame. And surrounding areas. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for coming. While the last few people drift in, I'll tell you how the show's going to go, because you've normally got a miserable fucker with you, haven't you?
Yeah, there he is.
Someone who's been saying all the way, oh, what time's it start? Oh, what time's it finish? Can you take your drinks in? Can you take your drinks in? For that miserable fucker, this is how the show's going to go. Now, normally at these shows, the main act as a support fella, he comes out at the beginning. He's normally young and trendy and hip. He's got a smart haircut. He goes, hi, hi. You can follow me on Twitter. Hashtag laugh a lot. Does anyone know what that means? People say to me all the time now, hashtag this, hashtag that. I say apostrophe, fuck off, mate, will you? Drive someone else mad. Now, that fella normally does about half an hour, then have an interval, and then the main act comes out. Now, I don't do that. I do this bit myself. Bluff you up a bit. The reason I like to do this bit, people, is I need to tell you where I'm at. There's a few things we need to talk about, OK? First thing we'll look at is the money. OK. As you know, I grew up on a council estate. I've not made a big thing of it. Back in the 70s, when people are proud to live on a council estate, no stigma, lovely. People would come in the pub, I've got myself a council flat. You go, woo-hey! If you just get on the sick, you'll never work again, son. You'll never work again. We weren't the piss poor family on the estate. Every estate had a proper piss poor family, didn't it? A family you used to look at and think, we're skinny. But you're fucking poor, man. How did you get that poor? You know, you'd look in the house, you think, oh, no wallpaper. Sugar still in the bag on the table. The family where the brother had a baby with the sister. You weren't that family. Regular working class family, you know, provident checks, free school dinners, grant uniforms. Things got a bit tough when they put the old man in prison. He did it. At least I got to sleep in me mum's bed, every clad. So, let's jump to the present. Right, okay. Three major sellout UK tours, platinum selling DVDs. Right, I'm fucking loaded, all right? Absolutely caked up beyond belief. It's shocking. Now, I'm fine with it. It's fantastic. It's fucking lovely. The management are a little bit spooked. They worry about these things, the management. They called me in. They said, Mick, look, you're from the people, you're of the people, you're one of the people. But if they find out how much money you've got, they could go right on the turn. I said, look, don't worry, I'll talk to them about it. Then they really started panicking. So this is what I've come up with, people. For the next couple of hours, you've got to imagine I am still like you. But with money. All right? And we all get along fine. I ain't got to keep bullshitting ya. Saying things like, I was on the train the other day. I wasn't on the train the other day, all right? I'm in the back of a Mercedes Benz. Tinted windows, champagne on ice. I've started buying mad shit I have for this money. I bought myself a leaf blower the other day. It's not for the garden. It's so I can blow the £50 notes out of the way. And I went to the kitchen. Who put that tenor in there? Fucking embarrassing. So, right, that's the money. Put that to one side. Put that to one side. I'm a celeb now. I didn't want to be a celeb. What sort of a maniac wants to be a celeb? I know I'm a celeb because they keep phoning me up. Do I want to go on this show, that show? They said to me, would I like to go on Strictly? I said, oh, come on, but only if we can have an ecstasy night. Everybody's got a double drop. Don't fuck about that. Actually, don't double drop at the moment. The pills are getting proper powerful. Behave yourself. Drug culture has changed in the UK, hasn't it? Changed. When I was growing up, teenagers had to hide the fact they were taking drugs from their parents. Now parents have to hide the fact they're taking drugs from their teenagers. It's all gone a bit skew-iff. Family parties can be a fucking nightmare. Because you turn up and all the generations are there. And what happens is the teenagers hang around, just hang around, talk to the old people. Teenagers are very serious people now. Oh, they're so earnest and serious. They come across, they've got their tofu. I've got my tofu, got my mineral water. I'm going fucking mental tonight. And they come over to you. Hi, hi, I'm Tom. I'm 6'7". I'm 15. This is India. We met in Africa. We were building a well for the locals, you know. They didn't want it, but fuck it, we built it anyway. We're going on a march tomorrow, Mick, against lactose intolerance. Would you like to come along? Over Tom's shoulder is a slightly overweight, balding man looking at me and going, obviously. I fancy it. Who don't fancy a livelihood at a family party?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.